Northeast Nigeria. How is that system run? A man will go to his village. He will pick 4, 5, 6, 7 boys and ask them to come and live with him. He feeds them, he will house them, he provides their clothing, but he does not pay them salary. They are with him. They report in his shop every day. This thing I'm saying has been a study at Harvard. They were trying to understudy the system. They will report. After about 6, 7 years, they will graduate. He will settle all of them into their own shops. These 7 people that he has settled into their own shops, the moment they become a bit stable, they go back to the village and take another 7. Why can't government understudy this and fund these kind of projects? These are projects, these are things that they are in tandem with our culture, they are in tandem with our understanding, they are things that we have tried and tested. So when we have money, trader money, this money, that, let us look at how we can utilize these kind of concepts. Another one, the ESUSU, that is the guild system that is very prevalent with Southwest, and it is even reached an advanced stage now, the way they use the ESUSU. And it is backed by women. They contribute with money regularly. It is the turn of Mama Lagbaja or Mama Tamedu to collect money. And at the end of the day, they have done it in such a way that it is the person in need at a particular time that collects. Where there is exigency for them to have an extraordinary thing, they know how to do it. The idea is none of us will be left behind. We all will grow together. Those are the kind of initiatives that government should look at how to support. Put in guidelines, put in rules and regulations, understanding them very well, put in a regulatory framework, but utilize them. The beauty of it is you can audit it and know what has happened to the funds. There was we may look at the above instances as archaic models, that is the SUSU and the rest of them. We may look at them as archaic models, or at best, historical artifacts. I dare say they are much more. African traditional models and the policies and rules guiding them reflect not only the moral and ethical principles of the social order in which the models operate, they also integrate the spiritual needs and aspirations of their intended subjects.